Hi everyone, welcome to Loving Life, and today I'm going to talk all about keto, my progress and how I started, and maybe it will help you. So let's get started. Let's talk progress first. Now, for those 3 weeks, I'm filming it day or two after my third week, and I was weighing myself only on like on the 3 week mark. So yeah, on those 3 weeks I lost about 11 pounds or five-ish kilograms. Now, most of the weight loss I did in the first 2 weeks. I know that part of it for sure it's water weight. As I explained in previous video, there is a lot of water retention when you eat carbs, and I lost this, and at least half of it it's water weight for sure, but I'm not sure if it's all of it. In last week I didn't lose anything, but I was sick. Actually, when we came back from United States, I got sick, the cough, the all nine yard, I know, throat, you know, all of this. And I know that sickness sometimes can slow the weight loss. I hope it is, but you know, who knows what it is in the end of the day. What I did lose a lot, it's the inches, okay? And I have here photo of the measurements that I took. So Just a second. Okay, I lost for my waist about 3 inches, which is a lot. And I lost on my thighs, I think, just a second, about inch from my thighs. So yeah, I definitely lost inches there. The only place that I didn't lose the inches, it was my legs. But you know what, I carry my weight in my lower body the most, and upper body too, but still the most I'm carrying the lower body, and it's known that this part will go away the last. So that was all about my progress. And now the photo. Talk about what is keto. Keto diet, ketogenic diet, it's a diet that your body is using fat rather than carbohydrates for its fuel. In order to achieve this, you can have a couple of things. One, it's to be that the body will be in starvation mode. And then the second one is by dietary fat. When you eat about 75% of calories from fat rather than from carbs, about 15% of protein, and the rest is carbohydrates. Now you need to understand it's calories, not the amounts. Okay, let's start with how to start this keto diet. Now I want to talk briefly about who can benefit from a keto diet. People who are on diabetes type 2, they're very great candidates for this type of diet, or any condition that caused by insulin resistant, which is polycystic ovary syndrome, is for sure one of those conditions. Now, please don't start it by yourself. Always go to doctors, you know, and ask them before you jump in anything. Okay, so now how should people ask me, how should you start this diet? And I have a list in my mind. I hope I will remember everything. If not, I will add in later videos. So yeah, first and foremost, clean your house. I mean, I mean everything that you really, 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 really like and love, and it's carby and you tend to binge on or you tend to go to, please get rid of it. Or at least put it aside if you have, you know, significant others that are not going to do it with you. Put separate place for your, sorry, only for yourself, a separate shelf, and you will know that this shelf is your shelf. Now, all the approved snacks like nuts, by the way, two nuts that really good, it's walnuts and pecans are extremely good for this. Be very careful with cashews, because cashews are not actually a nut, it's a legume, and it have a lot of carbs, so be very careful of cashews, but the rest you can have. Almond somewhere in between. So yeah, nuts, type of cheese crackers if you have, pork rinds, something that you can snack on. Fill this, place. I love to fill it with tuna. I really love tuna. So a couple of cans of tuna I almost always have there, because if I'm really hungry and I need to snack or something fast and etc., I open a can of tuna and with some, spicy sauce or mayo, and I'm good to go. So yeah, anything that you can find. I didn't find jerky that it's not sweetened. So if you can find jerky that it's not sweetened, it's an excellent snack, but be very aware of it that most of them are sweetened. Now, second of all, it's again two ways. I started with intermittent fasting, which means that I'm not eating in between 16 to 24 hours a day. Like if I ate, like the last time I ate at 4, sometimes I'm not eating until the 4 for the next day. But most days, actually I do it only twice a week or so, most days I'm not eating from 16 to 18 hours a day. Again, my lifestyle absolutely proves this. And another thing, I'm really not hungry in the morning. So for me, it's second nature. Be very aware, if you are one of those people that wakes up hungry and you really want to eat, don't push yourself, at least for the first 6 weeks. Let your body go into the ketosis and let your body, eat 3 meals a day, how you usually do. This way you won't feel deprived and you won't feel, too shaky and etc. I never ate before 12 anyways. So for me it was so easy. It was like second nature. The first day that I did it, I didn't eat for 16 hours and then I ate something, and by evening I didn't want to eat the second time. So play with it. Another thing, really download your macro counter. I can't stress it enough how important the macro counter is. I'm using, it's called a Carb Manager, and you can enter most of your food inside and know how much you ate, carbs versus fats versus, all your macros. I really love this Carb Manager. Actually, I didn't try anything else. I started with this and I'm okay with this, and I love and I'm continuing. So maybe there is some better app out there. I love this one. Another thing, I have a food scale. I have food scale. So I put it on top of my, table, and if I want, nuts or I want something, I'm throwing on the food scale just to see how much it weighs. I have pretty good eye for the amounts of food that I can prepare, because I did a lot of recipes and I'm cooking a lot. But at first I need to know how much is 15 grams versus how much is 30 grams, like how much is, 2 tablespoons versus quarter cup or like 4 tablespoons. So I need to know. So now I already taken like all these 15 grams of my nuts, so I know how much it is. So this is another thing. If you have food scale, sorry, please put it on top of your, somewhere that you can easily access and weigh your food, or at least put them in cups, like half cup, quarter cup, etc. It will be easier to count your macros. I know I was against it for longest time ever, but it gives me peace of mind as for now, and I can easily to tap it into my carb counter, and it will be easier and, easier done, and that's it. Like I can forget about what I'm doing, which is awesome. Another thing, on I got the full keto flu. So yeah, since I think second day, I felt bad. I don't know, I didn't feel well at all. I was like headache and whatnot. And this is probably the electrolyte problem. Because again, you're losing a lot of water, and I was drinking a lot of water. Another point, drink a lot of water. You will feel that you are drinking and you are dying from thirst all the time. It's normal. Everything is normal, continue to do what you're doing, but remember the electrolyte and salt. So Himalayan pink salt, pickle juice. I just put my pickle juice, pickles, fermented pickles, and the juice out of them, it gives you two things: the acidity, the lacto-fermentation, which is very healthy for you, the extra bacteria, which is awesome, and the salt and what you need, and more vitamins. So this is the best pickle juice that you can make, and the recipe is coming soon. It's homemade pickles. You can pickle any vegetables. I did the cucumbers, but you can do any vegetables with this recipe, and it's easy and it's tasty, and the vegetables are really good, and you can eat those, and you can drink the pickle juice, or you can, if you don't have, just drink the pickle juice, but please don't drink the sweet pickle juice from the butter pickles or something. Sweet pickle juice is not for you. So this is another point. What else? And again, be prepared with the foods that you have on hand, with the amounts, you know. And yeah, and it took me about 48 to 72 hours to get into the ketosis, and I know it because I had I did the peace trips. They're not so good, and if you're dehydrated, it will show. They're not good, but by my feeling and by my, you know, how I felt, and one of the indication is the keto breath. Some people think that it feels like sweet, but I don't know. I don't feel it's like sweet. I feel it like yikes, like this, which I don't like. So yeah, keto breath. Yeah, for all those 3 weeks, I never was kicked out of the ketosis, even though I had only 24 net carbs, and I still was in ketosis for sure. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you started keto, let me know. If you want to start keto, let me to know too. Now, don't take me as, you know, the all eat above it. I'm learning as I go, and I'm just reporting what I learned. I went to a couple of Facebook, you know, groups about keto, and I'm learning from them. One thing that I'm not sure if I'm going to do or not. Some of the people experience, you know, plateau like I did for a week, and then they cheated with the one meal, not whole day, one meal of cheat meal with a little bit higher carbs. Like one lady ate slice of pizza, the other one ate sweet potato or something. Like it was a full discussion with a lot of people, and they found that actually after the plateau, when you have one carb meal, they lost more weight, which is interesting. So maybe I'll do this, I will try this. So that's another thing to consider. Again, I don't know, maybe if I will try it, I will report it for you for sure.